If you need to clone drives and need a USB solution for docking two NVMe drives, then the Sabrent Dual SSD enclosure with its offline cloning feature and has an active cooling fan might make your life just that little bit easier. Hello everyone, it's Mike from Sabrent here, and if you enjoy tech videos and tech related videos, then make sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you stay updated. So let's check out what you get in the box. So you're first of all introduced with the enclosure, so it's a really nice enclosure. I will get into this in a moment, but let's check out some of the accessories that you get. So you get the DC power input adapter. And then included in the box, we have two USB cables. So one is a USB Type-C to USB Type-A cable, and then a USB Type-C to Type-C connection. And then inside, lastly, we have the rubber nubs for installing the SSD. So we give you a couple extra than needed. And then we have some documentation, so the warranty card, as well as the instruction manual. So the enclosure, it has a USB 3.2 connection, meaning that you'll get up to 10 gigabits per second, but it's also backwards compatible with both 3.1 and USB 3.0 ports, but obviously running at their respective speeds. Now, if you want a Thunderbolt dual enclosure, we do have one just over here, and this one here is Thunderbolt compatible, and I'll leave a link down in the description below for the video if you want something that runs a little bit faster and you don't need the offline cloning feature. The full aluminium structure of the enclosure helps to keep the NVMe SSDs cool and improves its maximum heat dissipation. This weighs a little over 280 grams, making this very portable. On the top, as you can see, we've got some holes, and then on the sides, we also have some holes, and this is for the active cooling fan, which further improves the cooling of the SSDs inside. This means that when you are pushing the drives, you will less likely thermal throttle the SSDs inside. To open it up, it is really simple. As you can see, you want to head to the part where it says open, and there's a small tab, just push it open and bam, there you go. Did I mention it's also tool free? Inside, as you can see, we've got two NVMe slots labeled A and B, and this will be able to support NVMe M.2 drives. So I've got two of our Sabrent Rocket SSDs, and the reason for that is because they are fast, reliable, and really affordable. To install it into the enclosure is super simple. So what you wanna do is you wanna make sure that you've got the keyed part slotted in correctly. So just make sure it is slotted in firmly. Then you want to grab one of our rubber nubs and you want to slot it into the drive, as you can see. And then you want to push it in until it's securely in the hole like that. As you can see, a really simple and easy tool-free experience. So I'm going to slot the other one in, grab the nub just over here, and then pop it in. And as you can see, the SSDs are installed. So then you just want to close it up, make sure the feet are obviously pointing outwards, click it into place, and you're ready to go. Just to let you know, you can run just one drive for now and then install a second drive later on, and it'll work just fine. When plugged in, the computer will see it as two drives, which you can run independently. So you can choose to work off one of the drives and then store your files in another if you wanted to, but you can also run it in RAID or Strike mode as well. I do have separate videos showing you how to do it on both Mac and PC, which I'll have linked down in the description if that's the setup that you want to go for. If you need to clone an SSD, you can do this all without a computer, thanks to this offline feature. Make sure that you have disconnected the enclosure from your computer and then install the SSD that you want copied into slot one, which is this one over here. And then the data that you want it to be copied to the SSD, you want to have it in slot B. Then at the top, you'll see a clone button and you want to press and hold that for a couple of seconds. And then you'll see the LEDs going from 25% all the way to 100%. Once the LED has reached 100%, that means it's all completed. Then you just want to power it off by pushing the power button just on the top here. Then open up the enclosure, uninstall the SSD that you have copied all your data to, and then plug it into your computer and all of the data should be intact, ready for you to use. This is a very versatile and unique enclosure because not only will you be able to run your NVMe SSDs for both Windows and Mac with no drivers needed, you can also run it in striped and RAID modes. And the offline cloning feature means that you can just set it and forget it. This will actually be great for any professionals or IT specialists that need a flexible and versatile enclosure for their work. For me personally, this is fantastic because, as you can imagine, I get a bunch of SSDs from Sabrent through my door to test and try in many different applications. And being able to just chuck it into this enclosure and copy all of my data to any SSDs that I need just makes it as simple as possible because I can just push a button and forget it, carry on with my work until the enclosure has done it, and then I can use the enclosure itself to work from when I don't need cloning features. I'll leave a link down in the description below for you guys to pick one up. If you found this video interesting, then make sure to hit that like button and also hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you can watch more content just like this one. Anyway, look after yourselves and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.